Let's all play What's My Line? And now, let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, the award-winning actor and singer, the second most handsome man in the world, Jack Cassidy.
I thank you, Dr. Woods. It's my pleasure to introduce to you now a beautiful lady, a fantastic actress, and a writer of unrestricted bounds, the lovely Joanna Barnes.
It's my pleasure today to be seated between two very attractive gentlemen, both Broadway stars, Jack and the very popular Mr. Larry Blyden.
And it is my pleasure to present to you the lady who invented intelligent questions, Arlene Francis.
Here he is, the life of this particular party, Mr. Wally Bruna.
Thank you, Arlene, and welcome to What's My Line. During the next 30 minutes, you're going to meet some interesting people engaged in the most unusual occupations, which we hope will baffle this panel of experts. And in addition, the panel will face a mystery celebrity guest just a bit later on. But now, my friends, are you ready to begin?
We are, sir.
All right, let's meet our first challenger. Would you enter and sign in, please? Sharon? Moran. And Miss Moran, where are you from?
From Batavia, Illinois.
All right. Panel, may I tell you that when Sharon Moran does what it is that she does for a living, people watch. And now let's show the audience just what her line is. Let me remind you, when Sharon does her thing, people watch, and we'll begin the questioning with Jack Cassidy.
Thank you, Wally. Miss Moran, would you in some form, in the people watching you, would you in some form be considered an entertainer or a performer?
In some form, I would say yes.
In some form, but not really entertainer or a performer. So that's one down, Joanna Barnes.
Do you do this thing that you do in one special place, Miss Moran?
You mean in one location,
well,
one
yes,
city,
I mean,
or something like one office, something like
no,
that?
No, what I mean is like, here we are in this location doing this thing, theoretically.
I wouldn't say that specific, no.
No, I don't think so, so that's two down. Larry.
Miss Moran, when you're doing this, are you out of doors?
Yes.
Is what you do connected with sport in any way?
Yes.
When you perform this sport, do you wear something other than just normal street clothes?
Yes, I would say so.
Is the sport that you perform a winter-type sport?
No.
That's three down. Arlene.
Do you perform on or near water?
No, well, not really.
Well, almost no. I think I agree. Almost anything can be performed on or near water, but in this case, no. That's four down, Jack.
Miss Moran, in what you do, do you do it... is something else attached to your performance? Do you, let me give you an example, and I'll be quickly eliminate myself. Would you in any way have anything to do with automobiles?
No.
Five down, Joanna.
Miss Moran, is what you do something that would be considered more normal for a gentleman to do rather than a lady?
I don't think so.
I don't believe so. Six down, Larry Blyton.
Now, so far we have that what you do takes place on land. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. Now, it does not take place necessarily in the winter. Does it take place in a sunny climate necessarily, as in summer or in the wintertime in a warm place?
Yes, I would say so.
Is what you do in connection with this sport athletic?
Yes.
Does it have anything to do with either track and field or hunting?
No.
Seven down, Arlene.
It's a curious combination, but my mind works in a strange way.
30 seconds.
Do you use any kind of equipment when you are performing?
Yes, I do.
Would one of the pieces of equipment be a ball?
Yes.
Is the other piece of equipment something that might be considered golfing equipment?
Yes.
Do you indeed either exhibit or teach golf?
Exhibit or teach? Not primarily, I do not believe.
No.
Eight down, Jack.
You're not Arnold Palmer.
Very perceptive.
I'll take a wild stab at it. Are you the ladies' golf champion?
That's pretty close.
I think that's close enough.
Close.
Yes.
So.
The women. May I tell? May I tell you that Sharon is a professional golfer, and she is currently doing an off-season promotional tour for Lasting Beauty Makeup Finish, which is not surprising since Sharon was the girl, and listen to this, which Sports Illustrated called, are you ready?
I'm ready.
The Golden Goddess of Golf.
Oh,
how about that?
The three G's.
The three G's. Right. But you were also named the most beautiful lady golfer of the year. Do they also name the most beautiful male golfer of the year?
No, I don't think I'm beautiful as well.
When you're not playing golf, do you putter around the house a lot?
Matter of fact, I do.
Nobody else came up with it.
How long have you been playing?
For very good reason.
I've been playing since I've been 13.
So, well, that isn't too much experience then when you started
not
as a
too
teenager.
Much. Right.
And you've also, during your first year as a pro, were selected as Rookie of the Year, right?
That's correct.
Well, you know, my wife is a golfer and I'm a duffer. And some people say that I have problems with one shot. Well, I have problems with all of them. But I guess the one shot that most people have the problems with is chipping.
That's a tendency, right?
Yeah, how are you at chipping?
Well, that is one of my strong areas.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Would you mind showing us how, really, a professional chip?
Sure, I'd be glad to.
Do either of you play golf?
No. I happen to be a wonderful golfer.
How about you, Larry?
No.
All right. Jack, why don't you join us center stage?
Why
please,
not?
Would you? Come on over here, Jack, on my side. Then we can watch exactly how Sharon does this. Now, I understand that Sharon is going to consistently knock the golf ball through the hole. Is that right, Sharon?
Hopefully so, yes.
Okay. There's one, and let's see what you're going to do.
I'd just like to give a few little pointers on chipping.
Wait, no, let's say she doesn't do it.
You're on.
Well,
what? You're on.
Yeah. I'm only teasing.
Right, I just give a few pointers on chipping quickly. But you grip down on the club near the bottom of the grip.
Watch that.
Play the ball off the right foot, pull the left foot a little bit back with an open stance. Then the weight is on the left foot and kept there during the shot. And just a very slow. Oh, that's low.
That's one.
That's one. I get three chances.
You get another chance.
All right. All right, I was a little low on that. The one thing I want to do is keep the left hand moving towards the target as such. If it breaks this way, you have trouble. Yep.
Hey! There's one more. Close, but no cigar. During rehearsal, she did 293 out of 293, right? Something. No, really. Yeah, three out of three. Okay, Jack, let's see how well you can do.
Oh,
it's a very simple thing to do. We'll let you use the club. All right. What do you want to wager on this one?
I could probably.
Obviously, misses the ball.
Oh,
I'll get your own clubs, Larry.
Okay. Oh, what a swing. Look at that form. Weight on your left foot.
I'll be the judge. You're right, it is on the left foot.
Oh, look out.
One more. Oh,
would
was,
you care to try another one, sir?
May I try another one?
May you try another one? You
may. Right.
Okay.
Oh, that's
oh
better.
Close.
Better.
Okay, Jack, you got one more, and if you don't make it this time.
Oh, that's better. Now you'll do it.
All right.
You did get all three.
No problems at all, Jack. Thank you so much. You were great. And Sharon, thank you for joining us on What's My Life. Would you say hello to the panel, please? What's My Line will continue right after this word. All right, now we're off to a good start, Jack. Arnold Palmer isn't in really any serious trouble from you.
But I have a lovely handwriting. It's the Palmer method.
Oh, I'm so tired of this Christmas crowd we got.
All right, let's
Easter.
Move along. Every day is Christmas on What's My Line.
That's
let's move
I'm
along and
it.
Meet our next challenger. Would you enter and sign in, please? Oscar Wasserman. Looks like you're traveling light.
Huh? Not too light today.
Not too light. Where are you from, Mr. Wasserman?
Chicago.
All right. Panel, may I tell you that Mr. Wasserman deals with a product. As a matter of fact, he deals with the product which you see right here on the desk beside him. And now let's show the audience just what the product is. May I remind you, please, it's a product you're after, and we'll begin the questioning with Larry Blyden.
Thank you. Mr. Wasserman, can I look in that little bag?
Not now.
Okay. Is the product you deal with something that there's a thing on the front of that? When that comes, is that a latch?
It's a lock.
It's a lock. All right. So nothing is projected through that. Is that correct?
Correct.
Is it something that's used in the home?
Oh, it partly.
Could be.
It could be.
Is it used in one room of the home more than any other room in the home?
No.
No. One down, Arlene.
Is that a suitcase that would hold something other than a suit?
It's possible, yes.
Yes, it would.
Is it meant to hold something else than clothing?
Yes.
Is it meant to hold anything that is now or ever has been alive?
No.
No. Two down, Jack Cassidy.
Mr. Wasserman, what is contained in that suitcase or piece of luggage, is it in any form electronic?
No.
Three down, Joanna Barnes.
When people use your product, Mr. Wasserman, do they do it to improve some sort of situation?
Sometimes.
That's a good answer.
It's so sinister when the audience laughs like that. Might it be... May I assume that it is in no way therapeutic?
Its primary function is other than therapeutic, so that's a safe assumption.
If I watched somebody using this thing, would I be amused?
I don't think really amused, no. Four down, Larry Blyden.
Is there any moving parts on whatever is in there?
No.
There are no moving parts.
It's
just
Arlene?
Sitting in there.
Just sitting.
Does it hold anything that you wouldn't like to have loose around the house?
I don't think so.
No.
No.
You mean you wouldn't care if what was in there was lying around the house?
Six down, Jack Cassidy.
I may assume there's not a small Volkswagen in there.
You may assume that.
I may assume that. Is it in any way helpful or have anything to do with the body?
No, I wouldn't say.
I don't think really, Jack. Seven down, Joanna.
Must I touch it when I use it?
To a degree.
To a degree, yes.
15 seconds.
So I'm touching it with my hands, and do I touch it to a particular part of my body?
No.
No. I'm going to flip all the cards and tell
it's
you this.
Tiny
Mr.
Tin.
Wasserman has a very intoxicating product. It's called a portable bar. Mr. Wasserman sells travel bars for Everywhere Incorporated of Chicago, Illinois. And what's included in the complete travel bar?
Let's show the panel here.
We'll just set it up here, and then we can perhaps see it a little better.
It's a little bit of heaven.
That's right. This is our deluxe model. It has
the polished aluminum cups, corkscrew, openers, ice tongs. And here we have a special feature. We have a ice bucket cocktail shaker combination.
You mean you keep your ice in this as you
And
travel?
You can use it as a cocktail shaker. We call it the cocktail shaker that keeps it cool.
It'd be great on the Sahara, wouldn't it?
I should say so. And this little feature here, we also include a deck of cards and a score pad. And if we remove the deck of cards and score pad, a person can put their own transistor radio in there if he goes to the football game.
Well, Mr. Wasserman, it's a delightful thing. And you can just leave this if you'd like. No, I'm joking. Thank you so much. We enjoyed having you on What's My Line.
Thank you.
Could you say hello to the panel? There we go. What's My Line will continue right after this word. And once again, we have reached that very special part of What's My Line, the time we meet our mystery guest, panel of the blindfolds in place.
Yep. Totally.
All right, mystery challenger, would you enter and sign in, please? May I remind you, please, panel, it will be one question at a time. I'll give you 3 minutes to try and establish the identity of our mystery guest, and let's begin the questioning with Arlene Francis.
Thank you, Wally. Are you primarily known for your work as a performer?
Yes, at times, I suppose.
Jack Cassidy.
Would you be considered, are you in any way connected with the musical world?
Yes.
Joanna Barnes.
Do you compose and conduct also?
Yes.
Larry Blyden. Larry Blyden. One question at a time.
Do you have a great big fat hit on Broadway right now?
You tell me.
It's Carmen Cavallari.
Arlene?
Well, I don't know how we can stretch this out any longer. I have a feeling that it must be the gentleman that has worked with another very famous gentleman in a musical that has a very famous star. And is it either Andre Previn or Alan Lerner?
Yes, but which one?
Which one?
All right, take off your blindfolds and meet Andre Previn.
Thank you, Jack.
It could have stopped some time ago, you know.
Yes. Gee, I was all set with all kinds of evasive cleverness as nothing happened.
Well, it's just too much, and of course...
Good disguise.
Everybody has been expecting you, Andre.
I see. Well, that's good.
And, no, of course, the great hit they're talking about is Coco with Katharine Hepburn.
Yes, well, that's been quite an experience, and a happy one.
What has it been like to work with Miss Hepburn?
Well, it's remarkable because she is... she's extremely musical, and she's a really, well, that's what I call a big star. And it's great fun to watch her, and you know, both Alan Lerner and I stand in back of the house and take notes every night, so I've seen the thing about, 40 times. And I never get tired of watching her, no matter what she's saying or singing, and those are the things that, of course, I very often don't like what I've written, you know, but I always like the way she says it.
So. Have you added many songs or taken away songs and made changes, Andre?
Oh, I think the only thing that stayed was the title.
Well, isn't this the first musical that Katharine Hepburn has done? Isn't this really the first time she has sang on stage?
Yes, we went through that. I think the only other musical thing she ever did was she played Clara Schumann in a movie once, but she... She sang, she was leery of singing at first, and then Alan and I were so determined to get her to do the play, and she insisted on singing for us, you know, like an audition. And she came over and we said, what can you sing for us? And she then sang an unaccompanied version of Auld Lang Syne, and we said, fine, that's that.
So that's one of the, it seems strange for Katharine Hepburn to have to audition or sing Auld Lang Syne.
Well, that was her idea, you know.
Certainly.
She wanted to sing for us to make sure that we knew, you know, what we were getting in the way of a voice. But she's terrific. She really is.
And that's Coco, of course, which is now on the Broadway stage. Andre, thank you so much for joining us on What's My Line.
Thank you.
Andre Previn.
What's My Line will continue right after this. We're very pleased to have with us this week on the panel of What's My Line, Larry Blyden. And Larry, I know our audience has seen you hundreds of times on television game shows and on panel shows, but you also have quite a career going as an actor. With any luck at all. What are your plans?
Huh?
What are your plans in the acting?
Well, when we finish here later, I'm going to Hong Kong to make a movie.
Hong Kong?
Yeah. It's a movie that was written and is going to be directed by Burgess Meredith. And James Mason is playing a Chinese gentleman in it named YY Go.
YY Go?
Yeah, and the reason to go really is I've never been to Hong Kong before. So that's
what will the name of the movie be?
The Something of YY Go.
The Something?
But I don't know what the something is. I mean, I don't know
well,
if it's...
Well, go to Hong Kong and find out.
All right.
Anyway, we're delighted to have you with us this week. Larry Blyden. I don't know. I think the one mistake we made in this show was not giving Larry an opportunity to try to hit the golf ball, even though Jack claimed he was a professional golfer.
It's all right. Jack, it's all right, Wally.
There's no reason for both of us to look bad, and I'd much rather it was Jack, actually.
Welcome to friendly persuasion.
No, it's just that you're used to playing in the wind at Pebble Beach, I know.
I've been going for the makeup kit too much. It has nothing to do with sports at all.
But you were very good today, panel. That means you'll get another shot at it tomorrow. You too, Jack. And won't you join us, please, for What's My Line?
We come a-wassailing among the leaves so green.
Hey, guys, what does wassailing mean anyway? That's a good question.
Well, we're game show hosts. Why don't we ask them?
Okay. Does wassailing mean to go door-to-door singing carols, to shovel snow, or to eat and drink?
And the answer is A.
Singing! So, let's do it!
Love and joy come to you, and to you your wassail too, and God send you a happy new year!
This is Down by Bond with Teller. This is Gene Wood speaking.